One of the most charming of American Christmas stories lies hidden deep in old diaries written by the Moravians. They loved music and especially loved Christmas, so much so that they called their first settlement in the New World Bethlehem, founded on Christmas Eve, 1741.
Make way, make way, make way for Brother Joseph. The people made a little aisle in the crowded room for Brother Joseph. He squeezed through and went up to the Christmas crib.
This is our great day. Christmas has always been the great day of our town of Bethlehem, as it was of that other Bethlehem, where so long ago the Christ child was born in a manger.
In simple words, he told the story of the first Christmas of all, turning often to the miniature stable as he mentioned the Christ child, or the wise men, or the shepherds with their sheep. Then he spoke of the playing of the trombones while it was yet dark on that Christmas morning.
That was the people's faith put to music.
He wished all the children visiting in the town a very happy Christmas. Indeed, he did not see how they could help being happy with such a beautiful Christmas surprise they had been given. Now, Brother Polycarp came in carrying two Indian baskets full of red apples, which he placed at the feet of Brother Joseph, who began passing them out to the children. Sister Gertrude, her sleeve hung with strands of bright colored ribbons, gave each girl a new ribbon for her cap. And while Sister Gertrude was presenting the ribbons, Sister Felicitas was handing round little brown candles from a basket she carried on her arm. She gave one to everybody, from Brother Joseph down to the smallest baby. Brother Joseph touched his to the flame of the candle, which, now burning low, stood nearest to the Holy Family in the stable. From his own, he lighted Anna Rosina's candle, and she held hers to Anna Johanna's. Anna Johanna lighted one for the Indian baby and held it for him as well as her own. And so it went, tiny flames springing up all about the room as candle tipped to candle. The shimmering air grew fragrant with the burning beeswax.